Ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon. On behalf of BRS, the Belgian Raiffeisen Foundation and its partners, a very warm welcome at our fourth microfinance lunch break.
Zoals u weet hebben wij de ambitie opgevat om met BRS dit te organiseren samen met onze partner uit Luxemburg, ADA, met als doelstelling om op geregelde tijdstippen, minimum 2 keer per jaar, een eminente spreker te hebben die ofwel over de wereld van microfinanciering ofwel over de wereld van microverzekeren ons wat meer inzicht geeft, ons wat meer diepte geeft, zodanig dat wij deze problematiek die ons nauw aan het hart ligt van heel nabij kunnen volgen en mee zijn met de nieuwste trends in de wereld van microfinance en microinsurance.
KBC has a keen interest in microfinance, not because we are actually ourselves a provider of such services, but because we are convinced that microfinance is one of the means that can offer the poor in this world an opportunity to deal with the uncertainties they have to face on a daily basis.
After 30 years, microcredit, narrowly defined, reaches an estimated 150 million. Globally, and but we have the 2.7 billion without access to formal financial services. So not all need credit, but we are certainly far short of reaching whom we need to reach. So we need a broader set of providers in an ecosystem that works for the poor at the base of the pyramid, so that they can provide the broader range of services.
Poor people in the informal economy need access to the full range of financial services. Not just credit, but also savings, insurance, remittances.
It's really a pleasure to be here in Brussels. It's a special place for thinking about microfinance and new ideas. This has been a place where every time I come to Brussels, I feel energized by new experiences, new perspectives, new financing vehicles. And so this time has been very much the same way.
The talk today drew on research in India, Bangladesh, and South Africa, in which researchers spent time with 250 families, trying to follow every financial transaction they made, everything they spent, everything they earned, just to understand how they live on $1 a day or $2 a day, and how they meet their needs.
This woman's name is Pumza, and she's very lively. And she earns her her living selling snack foods. She gets a small government grant, and then she makes snack foods. This is from the intestines, the internal organs of sheep. She cooks them up.
What the researchers found profoundly changed the way they thought about poverty and the way they thought about finance and microfinance. So one of the things that was very surprising was that the families had very active financial lives, which was the opposite of what you'd think. They were borrowing, they were saving, they were using their friends, and they were thinking about it all the time. And we realized that it was because they were poor, not despite they were poor.
This is Hamid. He's a rickshaw driver in Bangladesh, in the slums of Bangladesh. Very, very poor part of a very poor city and a very poor country. This is his rickshaw. He doesn't drive it every day. He's the backup driver, the reserve driver. So he only gets the rickshaw when the primary driver isn't using the car.
We see that microfinance is important, but not in the ways that we expected. And the impacts of that access will also be important, but maybe not transformational. Maybe it won't help everybody exit from poverty. In fact, I'm sure it will not. But the hope is that it will help poor families have more financing to deal with the difficulties they're facing and to cope with the problems of poverty much better.
And so let me thank you very much for your attention.
The event for us in Murdoch is a reference. Is we study on his books, so it's extremely important reference in our studies in the market. So for us, it's an almost emotional event.
Je pense que c'est aussi un moment où les gens se rencontrent. Il est clair que il y a en Belgique toute une série d'acteurs, que ce soit dans le monde des ONG, que ce soit dans le monde de la coopération, des instances de la coopération, dans le monde académique d'où moi je viens, mais qui sont intéressés par la microfinance. Et il est clair que c'est intéressant d'avoir un petit moment comme ça qui permet, outre la réflexion du jour, bah, finalement de se voir.
Ik vond het prima evenement. Het was ook goed te zien dat er meerdere mensen nu op afkomen. Het heeft duidelijk aan populariteit gewonnen. Dus ja, prima. Doorgaan zo.
Mais ça fait plaisir de voir qu'il y a des acteurs qui vont de plus en plus en profondeur pour étudier, vraiment remettre en question les choses et s'assurer qu'on va dans une bonne dimension. Donc la conclusion, c'est que ça fait plaisir de voir que le monde, que la microfinance se développe, on le savait, mais en repositionnant et en reposant des questions sur le développement.
They are always very well organized events, and they always manage somehow to identify really the speakers who are really cutting edge, and that's why I think it attracts a lot of people besides my colleagues in the EC, also people from various MFIs, from NGOs, people who come from universities, from researchers. So it's a great event. I really look forward to the next one.
Er is een constante in het verhaal, dat is dat wij geprobeerd hebben om altijd sprekers van hoge kwaliteit te hebben. Ik denk dat we daar 4 keer na elkaar in geslaagd zijn. En de aanwezigheid die gaat in stijgende lijn, wat bewijst dat die techniek om een goede spreker te hebben die een onderwerp dat boeiend is uit microfinance en microverzekeringen kan naar voren brengen, dat het iets is wat dan aantrekkelijk is. En we zijn vast van overtuigd dat het succes naar de toekomst toe alleen maar stijgende zal zijn.